Lakes in the middle of Toronto. Money to our AIDS medication.
The Global Fund to Fight AIDS, Tuberculosis, and Malaria is still $500 million short this year and more than $1 billion short next year. At the moment, there is no obvious way to close the shortfall. It is almost inconceivable that the extravagant promises of Gleneagles are revealed as so fatuous that the Global Fund is now compromised. No one is asking for any more than that which was promised, but the Pavlovian betrayal of the South has already begun. Everything in the battle against AIDS is put at risk by the behavior of the G8. I remember back in 2001 in an op-ed for the Globe and Mail, I used the phrase mass murder. It's hard in the face of the annihilating human toll not to be driven to linguistic extremes. This issue of resources makes or breaks the response to the pandemic. It is imperative that the delegates here assembled never let the G8 countries off the hook.
There are some 13 million orphans in sub-Saharan Africa alone. Courageous grandmothers in these countries bury their own children and then pick up the pieces for the next generation.
He's got the African granny in his hand, he's got the African granny in his hand.
Walking because half of the children these grandmothers are left to raise die before their second birthday. These are children infected with HIV because neither they nor their mothers had access to effective, affordable antiviral drugs. So just grab a bottle of water.
Do you want to carry a sign?
Okay. He's got the warm sign.
Hello. Hi.
Blaze new trails.
Blaze new trails.
We shall not stop.
We shall not stop.
Grannies for grannies now.
Grannies for grannies now.
Unison. Turn the tide, walk the talk, blaze through trails, we shall not stop. Grannies for grannies now. Okay, one more time in unison.
Turn the tide, walk the talk, blaze through trails, we shall not stop. Grannies for grannies now.
All right, give yourself a clap.
Across Canada and welcome everyone who's come to join us. Please give yourself a hand. Let's go forward and do our chance. And don't ever forget that our government just spent $1 billion on a G20 security, and it can't afford to send more than one bunch of medicine to Africa. Think of that. Thank you, ladies. Have fun. And gentlemen.
Thank you.
Ready. On
the camera.
Sending the children in their care to school is also a top priority to the African grandmothers, just as it is to us here. They want the same things for their grandkids that we want for our grandchildren and our children. Like Canadian grandmothers and parents, they know that education is the best long-term way to pull their families and their countries out of poverty and to help their grandchildren experience the joy and opportunities that come with learning. Currently, some 38 million primary school-aged children, 38 million, in sub-Saharan Africa are not in school due to family poverty, school fees, and charges, and the devastation that the AIDS pandemic has had on the education system, which means teachers, administrators, and so on. Many, many more, especially girls, far outnumber these 38 million, the girls, have no access. No access.
Why did you walk in the rain today?
I walk for those other grannies. I have only 9 grandchildren and I'm exhausted. They have like 39 and 50 and they're caring for them and they're poor.
We were walking to change the tide for the grandmothers in Africa.
Good for the complexion. Grannies for Africa.
Grannies for Africa.
We were up and down the street. Dean and I were on the main street, walking and handing out to stores and so on.
Why were you walking in the rain today?
Because we were, I won't say it, we wanted to fight for the grannies.
To bring awareness and raise money for the grannies for grannies in Africa.
That's right, that's what we're doing.
The epidemic of AIDS in Africa. We hope to help the grandmothers who are raising their grandchildren.
Now, why were you walking in the rain today?
For the grannies for grannies.
Grannies for grannies.
Now, why were you girls walking in the rain today?
Because we are walking for the African grannies.
Granny for grannies.
Yeah.
We're grannies.
Granny? Yes.
Yes, all right.
Why were you walking in the rain?
I'm walking for...
Oh, we didn't feel the rain.
No,
it's
just
nice
a Scotch
walk.
Mist. This isn't rain. It's just Scottish mist.
Why are you walking in the rain today with a bunch of ladies?
Because we're privileged and the African grandmothers with their grandchildren are not. And that's why we're doing it today, so we can get the money to them. Boots on the ground for these grandmothers.
$1,108, and there's still pledges that haven't come in.
Oh, good.